Hello, future Gainesville Hawks. My name is Mr. Grinnell, and I'm the athletic director here at school, which means I'm in charge of all the sports. I know a lot of you like sports and play sports and are interested in participating at the middle school level. So I'm going to talk to you quickly about two very important things that you must do in order to try out for a sport at the middle school. The first one is a sports physical. This is a separate document than anything you do prior to coming to sixth grade. This is not your entrance paperwork or your shots, any of that. This is specific to sports, and it's a physical that you take to your doctor. Your parent will fill out a couple pages. You'll get the doctor to fill out, and you will hand it in to me. This must be done prior to trying out for a sport. Basically, it tells us that you're healthy enough to participate. The second thing you must do prior to trying out for a sport is attend a concussion training. We host these at the school in the gym prior to any sports tryouts each season. So there'll be one prior to the fall season, one prior to the winter season, and one prior to the spring season. You just must attend one in order to try out for sports for the entire year. So if you go to the one in the fall, you can try out all year long for all the sports and you're good because you've gone to a concussion training. Usually takes about 35 to 40 minutes, and you fill out a document at the end stating that you have participated, and you hand that in as well. So at that point, I'd have two documents. I'd have your sports physical on file, and I'd have your concussion card. Having both of those, you will be able to participate in tryouts for any sport which you would like. Now, I urge you, go online. There's more information. I'm trying to keep it brief here. Go online, go to the athletics page, click around, see if you have any questions. If you do, you can email me. My email information is there. Also, when you get your back to school packet, your welcoming packet, there is one page that's going to be titled Understanding Middle School Sports. This is a very important document. It kind of goes over what I just talked about, as well as gives dates on when tryouts might happen for each individual sport and contact information if you have other questions. So, again, sports physical and concussion training. Super important. Every year, sixth graders come in and they haven't completed one or both of those items, and they try to try out for a sport in the fall or winter, and I have to say I'm sorry, and I have to send them home. So, check out the information, and we look forward to seeing you in the fall. Go Hawks!
Hi, I'm Laura Harris, the Department Chair of Health and Physical Education. You should have received a document that shows the differences between elementary PE and middle school health and PE. I just want to touch base on two of those in this video. One, we change clothes in middle school for PE class. Students are strongly encouraged to rent a lock from us to use in the locker room. It costs $1. Students cannot bring in their own lock for security purposes. Students are given 5 minutes to change at the beginning and end of every PE class. Don't worry, we give sixth grade extra time to change the first few times. We also do not change clothes the first week of school. Winter workout gear is sold at open house during August and throughout the school year. We sell dry fit shirts, shorts, and mesh backs. We also offer winter workout gear that includes sweatshirt and sweatpants. Two, we have a letter grading scale for health and PE class in middle school. Students will be given tests and also need to participate in class every day to earn their grade. Example of tests may be physical tests or written tests in PE class and a project or written test for health class. If you have any questions or concerns, feel free to email me at harrisll@pwcs.edu.